wide scope when it comes to making a career. These jobs are the most popular domains to start your freelancing career. First, we have accounting and finance, computer and IT, editing, writing and proofreading, project management, data entry, and analysis. Now, apart from these jobs, you may also think of creative projects, designing, customer service, and admin support to take up as a job as a new freelancer. Hiring freelancers is becoming not only more acceptable, but more attractive for many businesses. This creates an incredible opportunity for people with useful skills to start a freelancing business and eventually grow that into a sustainable self-employed career. To do so, first define what are your expectations from this business. Without clearly defined, easily measurable goals, you're going to have a very difficult time getting to where you want to go. Is freelancing a path to just earn extra income on the side for your day job? Do you eventually want to become a full-time freelancer because of the lifestyle benefits of being your own boss? Or are you looking to use freelance as a stepping stone to eventually achieving a different goal entirely? Only after you have the clarity around where you want the freelancing business to take you can you start backing into your short-term goals that'll help your freelance business become a success. Then, choose a profitable niche for yourself. Let's assume you're a graphic designer by trade, or at least you've been building your skills with Adobe Illustrator and Photoshop in your free time. Clearly, there are a lot of competitors in your industry that'll be willing to charge much lower rates than you, no matter what you do. There are people from all over the world with lower cost of living that'll always be willing to accept lesser paid gigs than you. Get over the idea of trying to compete on price as a freelancer right now. Instead of taking any graphic design project that comes your way, choose to concentrate solely on infographic design for a startup blog or writing ebooks for enterprise tech companies. Choose an area that genuinely interests you and focus on becoming the best designer in that narrow space. That's how you really find the right side hustle niche. Once you've built your skills to a level that you can confidently charge a premium for, then you're ready to start your freelance business and look for your ideal clients. Once you've made yourself invaluable within your niche, you'll have a platform by which you can expand your freelance business in any direction you'd like in the future. Rather than stressing about how you're going to get from step 0 to 100, take freelancing one small step at a time. Progress begets progress with your side hustle. Remember to identify and analyze your target clients. Your goal is to build your authority and eventually be seen as the go-to resource for a specific type of client. Do that well, and you can unlock your true organic business growth. By appealing so well to a narrow, well-selected niche, your target clients will have a very quick path to deciding that you're the best person to help them with their projects. This, above all else, is the path to charging premium rates without anybody batting an eye at the first price that you throw out. Build a quality portfolio website. It's often the first impression a potential client will have of you, your style, your work, and the past clients or companies that you've worked with in your freelance business. You need to effectively communicate the services that you offer and who they're for. Beyond that, you need to sell yourself on why you're the best person for this type of work. Fix strategic prices for your services. From a pure numbers perspective, this freelance rate explorer from Banzai is as good as it gets for determining what your expected hourly rate should be for your industry. There are tons of great tools out there for double checking that you're charging enough to meet your income goals and your expense levels. Mention your clients in your portfolio. Look ahead at the content that you plan on creating for your website over the coming weeks, and keep a running list of the companies that you want to feature whenever possible. Then, once you publish something that mentions them, take a few minutes and reach out to them and let them know. And lastly, if you are working, do not mix your main or day job with your freelance work. Don't do anything to jeopardize your full-time employment, as you still need it to sustain you while you grow your freelance business. The following are the things you do not want to do: breaching any contracts or agreements that you've signed with your employer, working on your freelance business during company time, and using company resources, computers, or paid-for blogging tools within your freelance projects. There are a few qualities that you should possess to set yourself up for freelance success. While not an all-encompassing list, these important characteristics will give you an idea of where you should focus. Starting with discipline. There's no boss watching you out of the corner of their eye or colleagues to judge you when you spend an hour online shopping instead of working. Discipline is necessary to stay on track. Persistence. It's always important, but particularly when you're getting started as a freelancer and desperately trying to track your work. Organization. You're responsible for a lot of different tasks. You need to keep track of your income and expenses. You need to promptly reply back to your client emails and stay on top of your deadlines. You need to keep your files sorted and your workload streamlined. And most importantly, be vocal. Being a freelancer involves a lot of communication. You need to be willing to have the hard conversations, like negotiating a higher rate or breaking up with a client, and handle them tactfully and professionally. There's no boss or other colleagues to take care of that hard work for you. Having control over your workload, the clients you work with, and your income is a big benefit of freelancing. When you freelance, you are in the driver's seat. You determine what jobs to take on, which clients you want to work for, and your pay rate. Depending on your level of expertise, it can be possible to work part-time hours but make full-time pay. Flexibility and remote work are also a big perk. Most of the time, working on freelance projects will involve working from your home office and working the hours you choose. You'll absolutely have deadlines to meet, but you will decide when and where to work. In brief, freelancing provides you with freedom to choose your clients, freedom to control your workload, freedom to decide and control your work hours, availability of a variety of job opportunities, and the freedom from a 9-to-5 job. With the ultimate control comes additional responsibility. As a freelancer, you are a business owner, and you need to stay on top of a few things, such as taxes, invoices, payments received, finding your own health insurance, and buying every piece of software and technology that you need to complete your work. Feast or famine syndrome is another real downside to freelancing. Some months you'll be full of work, some months you'll be full to the brim with work, while the next month may be a ghost town. You may be relying on a consistent contract with one client, only to find that they suddenly don't need you anymore. Freelancing requires good money management and constant sourcing of new clients. In a nutshell, you need to be aware that freelancing sometimes may cause the burden of self-employment taxes, rarely any extra benefits come a freelancer's way, unavailability of regular work, projects might get shelved time to time, the complete responsibility of managing and making your business successful, and just keeping in mind that this is isolated work. Dropshipping is an order fulfillment method that does not require a business to keep their own products in stock. Instead, when a store sells a product using the dropshipping model, it first purchases the item from a third party and has it directly shipped to the customer. As a result, the seller doesn't have to handle the product directly. The biggest difference between dropshipping and the standard retail model is that the selling merchant doesn't stock or own the inventory. Instead, the seller purchases this inventory as needed, usually from a wholesaler or manufacturer, to fulfill the orders. Two of the most common approaches for dropshipping are to seek out a supplier using supplier databases. It connects you and your store to thousands of suppliers. Once a customer buys a product, you'll be able to fulfill their order. As a store owner, all you have to do is check that the details are correct and click the order button. The product is then sent directly from the supplier to the customer, wherever in the world they may be. In brief, select the products that you wish to sell. Import items to your own online store. Set your own prices for the products. Accept your orders from customers. Then send that order information to the supplier, and the supplier will fulfill the order for you. The working progress of dropshipping is quite simple. It includes three simple steps as follows. The first is the store owner publishes products. The working progress of dropshipping is quite simple. It includes three simple steps as follows. The store owner publishes the products he wishes to sell on his online store. The customer then sees the product and places an order on the website. Then the retailer receives the details about the order and forwards the details of the customer and order manually or automatically to the dropship supplier. And finally, the supplier then packages and ships the required products directly to the customer with the store owner's branding. This is an attractive business model as it eliminates the warehouse costing of the store owner. Also, you do not need a physical business location. Marketing is a very important tool for the growth of any business. And to grow the dropshipping business, you need to employ the following tools. Develop your brand identity. Use a consistent color scheme and logo to make it memorable. Use relevant keywords to make your business flourish. Use strong marketing techniques. Use emails and social media platforms to inform customers about your business. And finally, use paid ads to make your business appear in front of a larger customer base. Dropshipping is a great business model for aspiring entrepreneurs to start with because of its accessibility. With dropshipping, you can quickly test different business ideas with very limited downside, which lets you learn a lot about how to choose and market in-demand products. Here are a few other reasons why dropshipping is such a popular model. The biggest advantage to dropshipping is that it's possible to launch an e-commerce store without having to invest thousands of dollars in inventory upfront. Traditionally, retailers have had to tie up huge amounts of capital purchasing inventory. With the dropshipping model, you don't have to purchase a product unless you've already made the sale and have been paid by the customer. Without significant upfront inventory investments, it's possible to start sourcing the products and launch a successful dropshipping business with very little money. And because you're not committed to selling through any inventory purchase upfront, like in a retail store business, there's less risk involved in starting a dropshipping store. There's also no hassle of managing your inventory. Running an e-commerce business is much easier when you don't have to deal with physical products. With dropshipping, you don't have to worry about managing or paying for a warehouse, packaging and shipping your orders, tracking any inventory for accounting reasons, or handling the returns and inbound shippings. You also don't have to continually order your products and manage the stock level. Because you don't have to deal with purchasing inventory or managing a warehouse, your overhead expenses are quite low. In fact, many successful dropshipping stores are run as home-based businesses, requiring little more than a laptop and a few recurring expenses to operate. As you grow, these costs will likely increase, but will still be low compared to those of traditional brick-and-mortar businesses. A dropshipping business can be run from just about anywhere with an internet connection. As long as you can communicate with your suppliers and customers easily, you can run and manage your business. Since you don't have to pre-purchase the items you sell, you can offer an array of trending products to your potential customers. If suppliers stock an item, you can list it for sale on your online store at no additional cost. All the benefits we mentioned make dropshipping a very attractive model for anyone getting started with an online store, or for those looking to expand their existing product offerings. Generally speaking, convenience and flexibility come at a price. Here are a few points to consider. Product quality isn't always under your control. Customer service might be a little tricky due to no physical contact with the product. Managing funds, returns, and exchange falls into your kitty. Shipping costs will vary as per your supplier's location. It is also difficult to have in-depth knowledge about your product. Let's have a look at all that we learned in this module. Defining strengths and weaknesses, and using this analysis to grow your business. How to use various personality analysis tests. How to use the online marketplace module to your advantage. How to start your own digital product business online and how to make it a success. How to sell your services on a digital platform. How to start your digital service business. What freelancing is and how to become a freelancer. The core qualities that you need to become a freelancer. The dropshipping model and becoming the master of your business. And finally, how this business can work to your advantage. When you start with your business, you learn so many things on the go that make you a more aware and stronger person, both in your personal life and professionally. You learn tricks of the trade and many skills that can help you run your business. The skills that you learn in any of the businesses that we mention are that you know yourself and your team and use that information for your growth. Finding your niche becomes the most important part of your life. Doing research and doing it right becomes the key. Analysis of the market, client, and customers. And of course, looking for global opportunities.